A convicted child sex offender argues that a judge should toss out his police confession, the evidence, and the charges.
The man making his own claims at a pretrial hearing today, where he is fighting burglary, kidnapping, and rape charges. His alleged victim died this week. News Channel's Geoff Greenwood, the only TV reporter there covering this unusual case and a bizarre hearing today. Geoff.
Hey, Kevin. Jack Hayes says he couldn't have done it, but at other times he says maybe he did something.
So it's my testimony under oath that everything you have is tainted.
Jack Hayes comes out swinging as he takes the witness stand at a highly unusual pretrial hearing. Hayes is accused of raping Frances Brazel in her home. She shared her story with us just days after it happened, and now she's dead. Hayes has since told several stories about what did and did not happen. One story is maybe he wasn't there.
The person I was back then is not the person who's sitting right here looking at you right now.
Which person was in Fran's house?
I don't know that I was in Fran's house.
But then Hayes says maybe he was there.
I remember fighting with Fran Brazel, but not in hitting her or anything else, you know?
Hayes gave police verbal and written confessions, which he's since retracted and is asking a judge to throw out.
You volunteered to provide a written confession.
So they'd leave me the hell alone.
This is not a confession.
Not as far as I'm concerned.
I broke into an innocent woman's house last night and raped her. She had done nothing to me. Her name is Frances Brazel.
That's what they told me.
Hayes also told police and his half-brother that he thought his wife, Kristen Hayes, was having an affair with Brazel, and Hayes was angry. Hayes also claims his wife, Kristen, who was close friends with Brazel, made this shocking claim after the alleged rape.
One of the things that she's told me is that Fran, you know, bless her soul, basically said that she believes that what happened between the two of us was consensual, and that the actual stuff that went on later had absolutely nothing to do with that.
Now today, Hayes focused on asking a judge to toss out confessions and evidence, claiming police improperly arrested him. Hayes also claims that since Brazel has died, that deprives him of the right to cross-examine her. And that's going to come up at another hearing.
And Geoff, at noon today, you mentioned that Hayes' wife testified this morning and admitted that Hayes tried to bribe Brazel. So yeah. What's the deal there?
Well, this is another little interesting twist. From jail, Hayes wrote his wife, Kristen, and in this letter, he writes, "I will agree to pay her or Brazel $30,000, presumably to make this all go away." Now, Kristen Hayes did not follow through. Now, speaking of Kristen Hayes, just after she testified this morning, deputies took her into custody. She's charged with 2 counts of perjury and 2 counts of forgery. She's accused of seeking food stamps for her husband while he was in jail, and then using those food stamps. So she was taken right into custody.
You've been covering trials for a long time. So have you ever, and not necessarily referring to just the fact that someone is representing themselves.
Which is unusual in and of itself.
It is unusual. We've seen that. But all of the other things involved in this case, have you ever seen anything like this?
I have never seen anything like this. This is by far and away the most unusual, arguably the most bizarre trial or proceeding I've covered. This is not a trial. This is a proceeding. He still has a trial. He's pleaded not guilty. This is, for a number of reasons, very unusual.